everybody. In this video, I will present you an example called Projector. The goal of the example is to play a video. So we will create an AV audio session and we will try to work so that picture and picture is enabled. We will deal with an AV player view controller. We will handle also a bit of AVI player view controller delegate. And we will display a background image when the player is in mode picture by picture. Okay. And we play with an AV player too. And we will observe the behavior of everything. Let's start by observation. Let's first have a look on the way this application behaves on a small device. Sorry. So you see, I opened my application. The video is visible. It's lagging a little bit, but this is due to AirPlay. And you see that, okay, I can activate controls. I can stop. I can go 15 seconds further or backward. I can reactivate. Here, it doesn't change anything because the screen is already at the appropriate shape. I can also change the volume. Okay. And I can have the control disappearing. So it behaves like any application of this type. Let's now have a look on the application on a large device. So it behaves exactly the same way, but the screen is larger, that's all. Here you notice that I have this control. Once again, it's for free. Hein? Okay, it's just to adjust. The video is in a movie-like shape. So I have to, I can fit it also by double tapping to have it the way I want, but it's normal for any video player. But also I have that. Okay. And if I do this, tap on the, I can have it full screen again. But once again, I can also do this. Okay. And you see that now I have left the application. Okay. And I can still have my video on while, for example, I'm opening a web page. Okay. It's funny because I could have a second video here. Okay. Of course, it's not a good idea because then it will lag. Okay. And of course, iOS is handling things. Okay. So it will stop one video. I can resume this one. Okay. And then it's totally okay. Okay. I can go back to the application. I can also close the application by just tapping on the cross. So this is the way this application can behave on a large device. So let's have first a look at the app delegate. This is there that I will configure the AV audio session. To do so, I need to import AV Foundation. Okay. I didn't mention that really when I was presenting the set category function, but it works. Errors are handled thanks to exception. So this is what I do here. I encapsulate this set category into do catch. Okay. So that if there is a problem, then I execute that code. I couldn't find a way to show you how it works when there is an example, but this code is very standard. It should work. Then I set two things. The mode is default, because I want to have a picture-in-picture, etc. So I take the default mode. And also, the category is playback. It's just for playback only. Okay. I think you can have a record too there. Have a look at the fantastic manual. And then you can set it for recording too. And that is all. The other applications deal with multitasking aspects of their application and not with handling any video. So now let's have a look on the view controller. The view controller here, of course, needs AV Foundation, but it also needs AV Kit. Okay, because I will need it to get the player, the controller, etc., etc. And I declare here that I answer to the AV Player View Controller Delegate Protocol. Here I have a player, I have a URL, so this is the first implementation I was experimenting with URL, but the problem that is it's a bit slow and it's not very nice to see because you have a stream for fetching the video and a stream for exporting the video for my recording. So I embedded the video, okay? Doesn't make any change. I have the background image I display when I'm in picture-in-picture mode, and the background is not on, so it falls. Then I have the view did load. The view did load is very classical. I create an AV player with my video URL. Okay. Then I associate this AV player to my player view controller, the one I created here. Okay. Then I add a child. Okay, this is a trick to avoid to have multiple controllers attached to the same system. Then I add as a subview the view of the player view controller. Then I set the frame, then I set the delegate, and then I draw in size because it might be useful. Okay. And I also delete the status bar because I don't want it, especially on a large device. So I have my function view will transition to size. In fact, it invokes the draw in size, and the draw in size does nothing unless the background image is on. And the background image should be on when you are in picture-in-picture mode. Otherwise, you have something on top of it. It's totally artificial. It's just to have an opportunity to fill those two methods. Okay. The method that is invoked when you start picture-in-picture. So here what I do, I set up back is on to true. And then I add background as a subview of the current views, the main view embedded in the view controller. Okay. And I set the size of this view. Otherwise, here, if I leave the picture-in-picture mode, I set its background on to false, and I remove the background from its super view. It's super, super simple. All the rest is handled by iOS. So, in the project, I have my video that I have imported. Do not forget to tick the checkbox copy if needed. I also have to declare that this video is a bundle resource, otherwise it might be not embedded because it's too large. Okay. And do not forget to activate in background services this first checkbox that deals with picture-in-picture mode, AV play, etc., etc., AirPlay, etc., etc. And this will activate all these items you may like to use in your application. That's all. So you know now how to play video. You have the know-how to play video, and you're ready to go to the movie theater with your device and the application you just programmed. Thank you for your attention. See you later.